Alrighty, guys, and welcome. Music off, knife round over, and we're going to be going into the game. Now, interestingly, I had advertised this as a train as the first map, but it seems like HLTV has got it wrong. So we're going to be going into Mirage, knife round over. Rogue is going to be starting on the CT side, flip side. They're going to be going on to the T side. Now, what is this? We're currently going to be playing or watching the ECS Development League Challenge going on, as well as the Caster Challenge, which I'm partaking. Straight off, we're going to be seeing the T's flip side playing for contact over towards B Palmas, but at the same time, they're going to get the connection that they're wanting. Now, KD going in for a lot of damage. He does get tagged. Only 59, but this information is out now. Electronic, he rushes by one of the CTs. They haven't noticed him. He pulls off a headshot. Lamy's going to get a kill. Killed rather, and now Victor coming in from Palmas gets 1, 2, 3. This guy, like I mentioned yesterday, he's able to count above the 2. And now it's going to be a 2-on-2 situation. The fuse kit is not in hands on either one of the CTs. There we go. He's going to get picked up by Bubble. He spotted out the T's as he looked to push through. World Edit and Blade looking at what they can do. But Blade, he's going to be falling a little bit short. We're going to be seeing World Edit going to be left in a 1-on-1 situation. The pressure's going to be building. He's got the Glock. Looking to see what he can retain here. He's got to potentially even just back out here. He's got 50 seconds to deal with, guys. There's no rush. There's no worries. Because every little thing is going to be alright. So, as we move further into this, just quickly recap. Whilst these guys are juggling around in apartments, they have previously faced each other. Rogue versus Flipside. When was the last time? Well, they've actually only played up against each other twice. And that was actually, if I'm right in saying, the Hellcase Cup, which was this year, back in January. And Flipside actually lost both maps. It was Train and Nuke, and Rogue absolutely destroyed them on Train, which was 16-10 in the end. But I think Flipside are looking a little bit hungry. They want to come back and try and win this one, but they've only got 10 seconds to win this pistol round. Unfortunately, World Edit, he's going to get tagged down to 12 HP. Bubbles made the mistake. He should have played aggressive there, but he can't see what we see. The bomb's gone down. 12 HP versus 100 and tagged right in the bloody face. He's going to get dropped, and that's a win for Rogue. Zero damage apt, ooh, for this player Bubble, but what he did allow was the bomb to go down, so we can see the economy is going to be on that stableness. We did see one of the teams previously force up last game for yesterday. I don't know if it's going to be happening today, though. I think they're going to be going in for the third round of buy, which is always a healthy buy up. But for the CTs, we're going to be seeing 2 UMPs, 2 M4s, and that classic MP9 from Cadian, rather. Not Caddy. Change your name, mate. And that also scary picture, nonetheless. On the flip side, quite literally, they're going to be looking a little bit more unionized here. Bolt from World Edit, who's even tagged down to 83 straight away. They've got 3P250s, and Cadian going to make full use out of this MP9. Gets a kill on Electronic. Nice bit of buff there. Waylander going to be looking to go in for the tag, but the UMP a little bit too strong in that distance takes him down. That's going to be the first 2 frags out, and they're both on the Rogue side, dropping 2 of the flip side players. So they're pushing towards mid, and World Edit going to be able to get the Deagle a kill out onto Tensky. Now Victor, he's going to be having the MP9 here, playing a little bit aggressive in towards apartments. He wants to make sure no one's going to be pushing here. Lommy, over towards mid. He's just going to be waiting for them to push. He's got the UMP. He can still kill them at this distance, but he has to be careful. World Edit has got some fantastic shots off with that Deagle. Smoke going down in towards Connect is going to kind of deny Markelov from being able to do too much. And Renee can do some damage, but Cadian, thanks to that team flash, he's going to be able to peek in, get a kill, back off, and looking pretty happy. And now Lomi playing aggressively. If he's not careful, his head could get ripped off. But Victor coming in from behind. They're not going to see him. He's going to get one kill and another following up. World Edit and the Blade did not see that coming. They got taken down, mown down like a blade of grass, I guess. It's a terrible comparison, and I really don't take offense to that, but hey-o. So next up, we are going to be seeing the buy versus buy, but we're going to be seeing a MP9 stay out on Cadian. I will question that, as we're going to be seeing on the T side a nice bar coming out. Very strict on the utility. They haven't got much cash left in the bank. 100 is the match. Players, apart from that, they've got a Glil, 3 AKs, and the AWP on World Edit, and that's something to be scared of. He's a very good shot on that gun. We're going to be seeing the sort of T presence over towards apartments. World Edit holding out, of course, mid in case there's a little bit of early aggression. And we've got the bomb hold back as well. There's no rush from the T side. They're just waiting for some movement to come in. Now, CTs, we are going to be seeing them with 3 defuse kits as well, so even if it runs down, they've got 5 extra seconds on the clock to be able to get that defuse in. And we're going to be seeing some pressure coming out over towards apartments, potentially, as Markelov ran all the way over there, but he's going to be backing off. What's that play on sort of the mines? Potentially, now Blade heading straight up against Arcadian. Tags him down, but he's not going to be able to get a kill. Not quite going to be able to finish him off. A lot of real estate here has actually been taken off, as you can see on the map there. Palace has been taken over by Waylander, but Arcadian with the MP9 going to be peeking in. Trades, picks up a Galil here. What a fantastic trade up there. Now Markelov, he's been spotted through the smoke. Tenski punishes him for this aggression. And from behind, Lommy coming in through ladder room, using that perfect sort of spotting area down in towards mid to be able to get a frag. Now Blade looks to be pushing in. He's going to be able to take out Arcadian. Nice raid, but Bubble, he's going to be countering that nice and easily. Now Wild Edit going to be left in a 1v4. He's out on sight. He hasn't been spotted. He gets a kill, but he's going to be left exposed. And then also dropped. And now that is an AWP for their efforts. So that's 2 AKs and AWP going into the 4th round. It's going to get dropped over to Arcadian. Look at his cash. He's got 8.3k. He's building up the bank here. He's going to have to spend some of that to be able to buy up. And Bubble, he's just going to get, you know what? Arcadian, I'm going to steal your idea. I'm going to go for an MP9 here. And on the T side, we're going to be seeing a pair of Deagles and a pair of P250s and a classic Glock coming out from Markelov. So many aggression to mid coming out from the T's, but they're going to get punished for it as well. Two of them slightly tagged down to around 70, and the grenade coming in, finishing off Electronic, and Arcadian and Tenski going to be opening up the map with the first 2 kills, and one following up from Tenski as well, and Bubble going to try and make full use out of this MP9, eventually gets a kill for the last bullet. And it's going to be leaving Blade in the mid to be able to get picked off. And it was so close there to be able to take down Tenski. But in the end, it's not going to be enough. Let's go into this next round. We are going to be seeing another buy. And this time, no AWP. There was no cash in the bank for that, I don't think. And Wild Edit, he has got a lot of utility. But as you can see, he spent 4.7k. Not able to sort of bump up that AWP unless he spends all his cash just on that one item. And when it comes down to it, probably not worth it. He wasn't high impact enough on the last round. He had the AWP, so why not just try and go for the AK? And they do have enough utility here on the T side to be able to do an execute in towards the A site. And they've got a guy Electronic over in towards mid. And he does really well in these situations over towards mid. If he tries to sort of distract the CTs, he could do perfectly here. Now Arcadian, he's over towards short. If they try and cross over there, he has got the shot on them, but we are going to be seeing the execute potentially coming out over towards A. Electronic just holding up behind him. He's playing very confidently here. If he's not careful, he could easily get picked, and now the grenade's coming in as well from the T side and in towards the CT. It's not going to happen. Bubble denying Waylander. We're going to see Markelov pushing in nice and aggressively over towards stairs. He spots out Bubble. He's in a lot of trouble. He's going to get dropped and picking off Tenski's head as well, but left with 1 HP. Lommy pulls out the trade. Blade, unfortunately, not going to be sharp enough, as Wild Edit is going to be left in a 1-on-3 situation. AK in hand, 13 HP on the board. Not looking so healthy for this guy here, as he's got the bomb. But as he makes his way over towards the site, we do have a couple of CTs sneaking in from behind. So he has to play aggressive here. He needs to go in towards jungle, but look who's there waiting for him, Lommy. He's going to be able to turn around, gets a kill, but he didn't expect Arcadian to be there as well. They were just rushing out on site. They were just like, you know what? We're just going to expose ourselves. We don't care. And it worked out perfectly for them. They went in for the trade kill. 2-on-1. It's obviously going to, who's going to win in that situation, especially when you're left with 13 HP. So although the CT's dropped a couple of AKs there, so they've only got one left. They still the M4s and the money in the back, whereas on the flip side, they're going to be left with a 4 Deagle buy-up, a P250 and 2 sets of armor. And even then, only one of them is half. And now Wild Edit, we're going to be seeing a boost coming out here, but it fails! Just like every effort they've done so far on this map. But the default rounds are over, with now 2 rounds into real ones. The kill through the smoke. Arcadian doing a fantastic job here for Team Rogue. And now Waylander missing his shots as he tries to push in towards A, not making it work. And Blade, the shots are just not working for you. He had the bomb, leaves it dropped down there. Now we're going to be seeing the last 2 T's trying to get as many kills as they can, trying to do some damage on the economy. Not going to be working though. Let's really have a look what has been going on here. So in the last round, we have actually seen this area, B being a bit of a concentration, and then a lot one player here holding it down in case any CTs obviously tried to push down here. But in the end, it was Electronic who was here, and he didn't have any impact in the round. The end, he just dropped off the face of the earth. These guys, they managed to execute into here, but Bubble was here. He eventually got dropped by, I want to say Waylander, who came up behind him and got the kill. But as soon as he killed him, Lommy came back in, went in for the trade, and the T's were just wiped off the face of the earth on the A site. So in the end, it just did not work out. So here, we're going to be seeing a slightly different tactic come out. We're going to be seeing the bomb getting dropped at the beginning of apartments and push over towards B. But unfortunately for them, there's three CTs waiting for them. Tensky is going to be playing with fire. He's going to get tagged down and eventually spray through the smoke. Electronic, that was naughty. Should not have been allowed to happen. Lommy's going to be playing for aggression. He wants that trade up. He doesn't want to give the T's any more rope than they deserve. But apparently they deserve quite a lot, as they've just been able to take advantage. And Blade going to be able to take down Lommy as well. This is fantastic here. And now Markov using that flash to be able to peek into apartments. Victor looking a little bit too early back into it. And he's going to get dropped down. Electronic spotted Alcadian, who's got the AWP. And he's going to get dropped as well. So that's an AWP recovered for the T side. And it's going to leave Bubble in a 1-on-5 situation. He's got the M4A1, he's got the defuse kit, he's got a lot of utility as well, but no flashes in the electronic. He's got the flash, he's going to peek in, he's going to be able to spot out the play, he's going to be going in for the shots, and there we go. This is the electronic that we want to be seeing. Absolutely fantastic work from these guys as we move into the next round. We're going to be seeing if Flipside can continue on this win streak, which is obviously only one so far, so really not that impressive, but it's a start. Everyone has to start from somewhere. So Rogue, they've been able to buy up into this now round, and they're going to be able to buy up into the next round no matter what happens, due to the round loss bonus going into the next round, and they've still got a lot of cash in the bank. T-side, they lose that one, this one, that's that round loss bonus reset, they will still have enough cash to buy up, especially if they get the bomb down. And if they can do a high impact damage on the economy of the CTs, it'll be a fantastic round for them. Tensky here, doing a little bit of scouting, pushing in towards apartments, but it's going to be the wrong place as we're going to be seeing the T's pushing towards the A side. The flash is coming out, team flashing themselves as well. The counter flash is coming out from the CT side, doing a good job at this, but they've gained a lot of real estate here. They've taken over the A site almost. And there we go, coming up from behind, it's going to be a CT, he's going to get dropped, but Bubble taking down Markloff on towards the A site. He's going to get cut off, but he's going to peek. Blade's going to get dropped, and if the T's aren't careful, they've just lost everything they gained so quickly. Lommy, he's going to be facing up against Electronic, who gets tagged down to 1 HP. Now, Wildrider going in for the aggression. He takes down Bubble. And now, Electronic going to be going in for the rotation. He's got 2 kills so far this round, but he's left with 1 HP. The bomb is over towards the A site. If they plant for ramp, it's going to be perfect position for him. But Cadian gets the kill onto Waylander from the side. Victor plays the aggression angle, gets the kill. Now, they need to try and work out where Electronic is. And he's going to get spotted. Headshotted Cadian. Coming in at the right second to be able to get the kill. Even though Victor doesn't have the defuse kit, he's going to be able to get it in the end, because they have plenty of time. And that's a very clean win for them. Even if they did lose 3 players, they're going to be able to buy up. I mean, look at that cash in the bank. Bubble, he's got 8k. And Cadian on 7.8. And this is what I like. Yesterday, we did not see a high impact play coming out from Bubble. He was quite low sort of impact on the sort of kill side. And look at that. We've got a James Bond Waylander. Get your suit out. Get your USB out. Well played. Obviously, it's not all about the kills. It's about the support positions, the playing as a team. Unless we're going to be seeing a different player coming out from the T's. They've got enough money to be able to buy up here, but if they're not careful, they're going to get reset. They're going to get punished for it. Now, Blade, he has come from underpass a few times, so CT should have a read on this. And remember, this is round 9 on the board coming out here. And if Rogue win this, they've won this half. Talking of which, Wildred, it's going to be looking to try and do a high impact here, go over towards mid, takes down Lommy, and Arcadian going to be pushing down into underpass, and Blade was reloading, had his pants dropped, and he's going to get punished for it, and that's going to be the bomb dropped, and the knowledge is out for the CTs. It could be recovered by now, but Arcadian would have given the information that no one was there to back him up. And that is always important. With the bomb carry, you have to be careful where you position him in such high-risk positions. Obviously, putting him down there stops the need for him to having to carry the bomb all the way down mid. But at the same time, he was by himself. And look at this. Cajun has switched up positions, so AWP is in a whole different position. They can't read this. There's no way for them to know that this has happened. Beforehand, he did underpass. Now, he's over towards apartments. Tensky, he's got a boost spot out towards short. Well dead it. As soon as he turns that corner, he's going to be exposed towards him. Markov going to be looking to use this Molotov to shove off the AWP that could potentially be there. And we can see Tensky, he makes full use of that boost. Takes out Warded Acadian, taking out Markov, but the trade comes in. Now Electronic and Wayland are going to be left in a very difficult situation. Victor taking the spray down on Electronic, and this is going to be leaving Wayland a very desperate situation, but he's being exposed in his head as well, and the spray comes out, and Victor looking a little bit victorious here with those two kills in that round. So with the round, or half win rather, Rogue are going to be looking pretty happy with themselves. They've got three players who are quite low on cash, but back that up, Cadian and Victor, they've got plenty of cash in the bank. But we are going to be seeing the MP9s come out, and a lot of money as well. Tensky going to be able to take down Markloff here, and Cadian, no AWP in hands. He spots out players, going for the far distance shots with the MP9. Does a lot of damage, but Electronic going to be able to walk away, or limp away, with 16 points of HP. Now Waylander with the P250. Going to be looking to play a bit of a distraction over towards Palace, but I think it's going to be an easy read for the CT side. But they have got three people over there. They've got Victor with AK holding over towards B. It's a nice strong rifle to back himself up with. Now Tensky's getting a lot of information here as well. They've pushed through in towards T spawn. What they haven't cleared, I don't know if they've actually even realized this, they haven't cleared Palace. As far as they're concerned, the bomb could be in Palace right now, and they've left A site completely empty. The push through on towards the A site could easily come out now, but Electronic's going to get a nasty surprise as the CT is coming up next to him, and he's got the bomb. It's going to get dropped as well. Electronic, and now Blade, he's going to get tagged down. This MP9 from Tensky, he's got a lot of money, but the 1D coming out from World Edit onto Bubble, he does go for the double spray with the, not spray, double tap rather with the Deagle. Doesn't need to. He got the kill. Now going to be left on 2-on-4. Going to be very hard to try and recover this for the T's, but they could do a lot of damage if they so wished over towards mid. Tensky, he pushes down. He takes World Edit out. This is almost an ace. He's going to spot out Waylander, but Lommy from the side angle takes him down, but look at the cash. This is just crazy amount of cash now in the bank. I mean, Tensky was a little bit lower than the rest. Now he's up at 7k. Cadian, 10k in the bank. Absolutely fantastic here. On the T side, they have bought up fully. World Edit. He has got the UMP. He hasn't got the AWP that he so wished to have, but the UMP is such a fantastic weapon. They can make full use out of it. Now down towards mid, Tensky is going to make full use out of this MP9, and I'd like to mention, Cadian still got his MP9 as well. Is this a misread? Or is it a confidence play? They've got 9 rounds on the board. They've got multiple kills over the top of Flipside as well. Cadian, he's in a perfect position, and Blade's going to completely expose himself. He gets a double. You would not expect that to happen with the MP9. It doesn't matter, though. He gets the kill, flashes out Markloff as well. If he peeks, he could get another kill. But we are going to be seeing the full back from Flipside. They've realized they're going to have to go lick their wounds. They've just lost a lot of their economy, and they're going to go in for the full rotation. CTs haven't got a read on this. They've got 0 players over towards B. If the full push and just, as the kids like to say, a YOLO plane came out and they rushed all the way over towards B, they could get the plant. So have a look at the map right now. Look at the positions. We've got Bubble, who's back in towards CT. He's just watching up behind them in case someone tries to push through window room, but that's not going to happen because we're going to be seeing all the T's gang up here. They're clearing each one of the angles, making sure no one's going to be coming out of these angles, and they're going to be pushing in, and they're going to be looking to plant right dead on the bomb site, and that's not going to be challenged. No one is there to challenge that. Now, as the utility's coming out, we are going to be able to see the rotation come in, and it is going to be nice and easy for this team. Bomb is going down. Water's in a good counter position. Markloff left with only 20 HP. We are going to see Bubble push through. He's going to get tagged down. Water going to get traded out, though. Victor going to fall to the gun. Oh, Markloff and Lommy proven too effective. Taking out an Electronic. And Cadian from the side angle takes down another. That's going to be a 3K for the man. They are racking and stacking these kills. And I'll just refer back to the fact that so far, Rogue have got a 2-0 perfect scoreline against Flipside in their history. over at the Hellcase tournament that they previously beat them on. And I think Flipside, they actually placed sixth in the last ECS league, which was season 2. We're now in season 3. Are they going to be able to make it past Rogue? One of the Danish Wonder teams that are trying to push through and improve themselves and one of the top teams. At least make it through tier 2 either way. Cajun playing aggressive with this AWP. Gonna be able to spot our player. Lags him. Electronic. He's only got 17 HP. Cadian does go in for the trade damage. He's got down to 44 HP, but holding him towards Palace. Gets the pick. Waylander gonna get dropped and well done it. Gets straight back onto Cadian. Feeling a little bit of revenge in here. And well done it. Straight onto Bubble. Equaling up the chances here. They've got that high chance rather, not equaling up. They've got the 4-on-3 advantage here. Makhlov going to be looking to peek around the corner against Victor. Is he going to get the shot? He does. Unfortunately for Victor, he got a little bit too greedy. Went a little bit too far. The gold digging only got on one thing, and that was death. Now, if the bomb gone down, what do you do with the CTs? You've got plenty of cash in the bank. Are you going to go for the kills? I don't know. They tried to, and Lommy's going to get punished as Electronic picks him off the UMP. Remember, Electronic was actually the guy at the start who got licked by Cadian, who then backed off over towards the A site, got a kill on the Wayland, who was peeking in the palace, and he got punished for it. And now the bomb is down over towards the B site, and we've got a lurker, and that's going to be Electronic. He's going to be pushing over towards palace, it looks like. And Tensky trying to save this AWP to try and bolster their economy here, as Bubble is actually down on 2.5k. I think he should be able to save this, but if he plays too aggressively here, he could be punished. There we go, so that's the second round on the board for Flipside. Looking to try and make a recovery here, but we've only got another 3 rounds to go this half. And we're going to see another full buyout from both teams. Looking very healthy from Flipside in regards to the buy, but at the same time, Rogue have got a nice counter buy. Cadian for the AWP, they've got the full utility, 3 defuse kits. And they've got quite nice positions here. But to try and counter this push into a world's apartments, they're going to have to be a little bit worried. Only Victor to do this. They're going to have to count on some quick rotations, but Lommy, he's going to be playing this classic position over towards the window, which he's done so many times now. Chucking down the incendiary grenade as well. This is going to shut off a few options for the T side. Now Blade looking to push through underpass. The footsteps may well have been heard. The grenade didn't do too much damage. He is going to make all the noise he can. I don't know if there's a tactic or what, but he has been given away. He's going to have to get flashed, and the spray comes out from Tensky. He now knows where two of the players are. This is quite good, some good information for him. Cadian, if he mollies this off, she's going to be able to do and flash it off as well. It's going to stop the push from underpass happening completely, and the pick from Wardad, it comes out, but Cadian with the trade out onto Electronic. And Victor playing very aggressively here. Wardad exposes himself. He could easily get tagged down, but the rotation is going to have to come in, as we're going to be seeing the put T's pushed down on towards B, but the kills are coming out from Victor. And Wolded is stuck down towards mid, and he's going to be able to get the trade though onto Victor, who had very low HP, but it doesn't matter. Now Tensky, he's got the M4. We're going to be seeing Wolded going for the flash and look to go for the peek. Is it going to be able to work? He didn't peek quite wide enough. He knows there's going to be a player there, but Makhlov goes towards the A side, gets two picks. It's going to be leaving Tensky up against Wolded for the kill. Is it going to happen? He's going to get tagged down. Now the block is going to be tagging him right down to 10 HP, and boom, he's going to get dropped. That's going to be the first streak coming out from Flipside here, taking to 2 rounds in a row for themselves, so 3 rounds total, with 2 rounds left on this half. And look at the economy on the Rogue side, it's looking a little bit desperate and worse for wear. Cadian, he's brought up the AWP, a little bit interesting to go for that option. The rest of them have opted in for the full force buy. Well, partial buy rather, they've still got a lot of money, and Bubble's going to be peeking, and Wildad is using one the angle to pick off Victor, shutting down any kind of push that they might want to try and do. But the information's there, they know they're going to be ganging up there, so CT's got their full effort here. Now Blade, you're going to be looking to push in, takes down Lommy, going to be pushing even further. Bubble's going to be fully exposed, but Tensky and Bubble make it a full effect of their pistols. do a lot of damage, but this isn't about economical damage. If they don't win this round, then it's going to be looking pretty dark for the next one. They're not going to have too much cash. Or even if they do have cash, they know that Flipside is still going to be able to have this, and the rotation is going to be coming in from the T side, and Electrox hit here to stop them bubble. Walk straight into his Corsair. Tenski knows he's there as well, and he peeks him. Gaining with the AWP is going to have to act fast here. He's going to be holding in towards Palm and spotted them out. Or did he not even see them? I don't think he did. If he's not careful, he's going to get picked out from the side. He does, but the quick flick and action from him is going to be able to save it down. And now the rotation coming in from Tenski. He knows he needs to back up his teammate. And if he's not quick enough, he's going to get dropped. And Electronic knows that he's got an AWP. He's going to be pushing hard and fast. And Kadian's not going to be fast enough. And he's going to get dropped. And this is a 2-on-1 situation. It's all going to be down to the man. Tenski, if he tries to enter in here, Markloff and Electronic are going to be able to go in for the trade here. Pressure's on. He's got no kit. He has got some armor. He's got the AK-47. He's waiting to try and equal it up so he can get the advantage here. And he can't, as Electronic is at the perfect counter angle as he tries to push in. And he's going to get punished. So that is another round on the board for Flipside, taking him to 4. But they really need to win this last one to take it to 5 to try and get up as high as they can. And if their CT side isn't strong, and Rogue are going to tell him a new one. We've seen Rogue do fantastic on the CFT side previously. And we've seen Kadian, thanks to his AWP by last round, only going to be able to opt in for this CZ. Well done, the AWP over towards mid. He goes for the wall bang. No, that's a smoke, Tom. He gets the kill, and Tensi is going to get dropped, and that's going to be an M4 dropped. And Kadian's going to be able to read this, go pick it up. Some extra utility in the bank as well. There you go. Flash for himself. And Lommy, he's just pushed straight down towards mid. And if Electronic peaks, he's got the angle on him. Waylander and Bubble about to face up here. Perfect timing, though. But Waylander's going to have the AK. He's got the shot on him. He's going to be lining himself up. He could expose himself, but no, he's just waiting for the angle. He knows he can't push around the angle too much, so he's playing it perfectly. Now, Lomi peeking out towards mid. Doesn't want to allow them push down too far, but Bubble, if he pushes too far as well, he could get dropped. And there we go. We're going to see Bubble get the kill on Waylander, but the trade over towards Underpass is going to be Muggle off on to Kadian. And the Lommy's only got 23 HP. That is, sorry, 24. That is not going to be too much there. Electronic. He's going to be looking to push down in towards B. He's going to get the kill onto Victor, opening up the B site completely. But they're going to have to deal with Lommy now, who's got the M4A4, looking to peek in and stop them from sort of taking full control here. It's going to be very difficult as the bomb has made a pass, and they're going to be able to get the plant unchallenged here. Markloff, if he trucks that grenade, that could get the kill. Lommy, he should have moved. Grenade is able to take him down. Now Bubble going to be left with 69 HP and a dream. This is the final round. He's going to have to act fast here. His blade exposes himself, but at the same time, Weldon knows where he is. Goes in for peak, takes him down. Final round goes to Flipside. Second half, guys, and we're going to be seeing Rogue start out on the T side with pistols, and obviously Flipside with their own set of default buy here. Blade opting in for the utility buy, defuse kit, double flash. On the other side, we've got Lommy who's going in for the utility buy, which is actually going to be a double flash and smoke setup. And we've got Kadian who's going to be playing over towards tunnels, I imagine. Here we go, trying to then rotate up through mid. Be able to do some damage here, but he is going to be playing up against Waldo. He's going to be looking to go in for the peak. He's going to get damaged though. 67 HP going to be left on the man and 68 on Kadian. That's going to be quite nice straight up between Shreen and two of them, but unfortunately for the CTs, we're going to be seeing the push in towards the A side coming in, and Victor going to be going in for the peak. Almost peaking a little bit too soon and almost getting team flashed. They've got the bomb down. Time is now going to be ticking. We do have the defuse kit out on the CT side, but they're going to have to be very careful. This is planted perfectly for the T's. We have got Kadian who's rotated all the way around, so even though CT is going to have to watch their back, the T's know no one's there. You don't need to watch that, but we're going to be seeing potentially Wilder going for a bait shot. He's going to get traded out. Now Markloff going in for Tenski. Blade trying to make the kill onto Lommy, but as soon as he peeks, he's going to get fired on, but he's going to be able to get the kill in the end. The headshot's raiding out. The defuse is coming out. It's not going to work out. Electronic gets the final kill on the bubble, and the defuse kit of it proves to work perfectly there. Team Flipside, who get the first win. But the bomb went down, so this is going to give Rogue an interesting decision. Do they force up? Do they go for the dangerous play here and try and force up into this round? It seems like they're just going to opt in for the partial buy, stay around the 2k mark, buy some utility, maybe go for a bit of a plant. I mean, why not? Get that extra cash in the bank for the third round to be able to buy up those AKs. And the early flash over towards the apartments is going to be able to shut down any aggression coming out from Rogue and the grenade as well, but there's no real aggression there. There's a little bit of baiting coming out from the Rogue side. Bubble was tagged down to 97. And we are going to be seeing a decoy chucked over towards Ramp, which I think played them made them a little bit hesitant. Waylander, he's going to be able to get this information, but if these two Ts can distract them well enough and play for contact, make it look like that's a play, they could do a very fantastic distraction. We're going to have one player left over towards B, and it's actually going to be Bubble who's going in for the push here, and the rotation is happening. There we go. Mr. Number 7. Ordered it has started the rotation over. The grenades are going to be set up over towards A, and we've got three players of the CT side over towards B. But I think this is going to be taking a little bit too long, and it might see in the counter rotation there. But Markloff, he's going to get the kill, and Bubble's going to get dropped, and now the T's, they need to act. Acadian going to be coming down mid, Blade. He's got his back turn. No, he peeks down in towards mid. He's going to get dropped, and this is where the action's going to be happening. They're going to be pushing in, but the Molotov cut them off. And this could be the end for the T's if they're not careful. They're going to be trying to push through the smoke and the fire, rather. And now Markloff in a perfect position takes down the bomb planter. They should have planted the default, but they went a bit confident here. But the shot through the smoke gets walled at it very low. Markloff going in for the counter spray, but Wayland are going to be able to make it work for himself. Now Victor onto Electronic, and Markloff pushes through the connector. Now Coyotean, M4 in hand, but Markloff has got the Famous, and he's going to be able to pick up the M4 for his team. Really well played by Flipside there. Really going to be able to bring it back, and even though we're going to be seeing the buy come out from Rogue side, we're going to be seeing two UMPs within that mix. Three AKs. It's not a full AK buy. And even on the Cadian, who's got the UMP, he hasn't got much utility, so it wasn't the fact that he didn't want to buy an AK, it's the fact that he couldn't really afford it. Yeah, I've got Lormy playing over towards apartments. Maybe a little bit of distraction once again. Molly's out the position to try and clear out, but the grenade tags them down to 84. That's got to be painful. With the T's playing a little bit slow like this, this is going to be putting the CTs on the edge. They've got two UMPs of their own, so the gun advantage actually goes over towards Rogue. For the time advantage, there's still a minute left on the clock. Make up your minds on yourselves on whose advantage that is, but Victor's going to be turning over towards his side. He peeks out Electronic, gets the kill. Now Blade going to be playing for contact. Unfortunately for him, the contact's going to be with his face as he's going to get dropped, and the smoke over towards stairs is going to allow an exit from Palace if they so wish, but the bomber hasn't gone down yet. They're waiting to try and do the crossover. We do have World Edit waiting to make the push in through connector, and the bomber's going to be going down. The flash working perfectly. Now Wayland are going to be coming in through mid as well, and through CT we do have one other player, but Wayland are going to be able to take down Lomis. That's when the UMP is going to be dropped, and it's going to be taken down to a 3-on-4 situation. The CT is looking to choose their battles wisely, as they are actually going to be backing off. But Tensky, he's holding this position. He's got two of them coming for him, but he knows he could take them. He's going to be backing off, though. He's going to be teaming up with... who's that? That's going to be Cadian with the UMP. If they push him, they're going to have the angle. The AK coming out. And now we're going to be seeing Cadian going for the greedy play. Takes down World Edit. Going to be able to pick up an M4 for his trouble. And Markloff, the last player left alive, is going to be over in towards apartments and kitchen. He's only got his low HP as well, 16 HP. And now Bobble's going to be peeking around the corner. He gets the spray, the pre-fire. Perfect. Gets the kill. Shutting down Flipside by there into this next round, and just look at it, it's all over the place. Most of them have around that sort of mid-tier level. I mean 4k on World Edit. He's going to need to save that. He wants to be able to buy up that AWP later on, so he just buys a Deagle. Says, sorry team, can't really drop you a ton of pistols. P2, P250s over a Deagle? I don't know, I mean, it's World Edit. Why not buy him a Deagle? So we got no one over towards the A site on the T side. We've got an aggression over towards mid. And they should be wary. They shouldn't push too aggressively against these pistols. I mean, with both these teams as well, on Mirage, their performances in the past, I mean, Flipside, they've been around a lot longer. But on both sides, I mean, Rogue, they've got 57.7%, get down to decimal points there, win ratio on this map. And flip side, slightly less on 56.5%. So almost a 1% difference there. Now, Victor of the AK pushes down short. He's waiting for Wild Edit to peek him. He does a little bit of damage, and Wild Edit not going to be able to get that Deagle shot off. Unfortunately, if he'd done that shot, that would have been absolutely beautiful. Nonetheless, KD has made his way down. He's going to be able to drop Electronic. He's going to be able to cover it up and Wild Edit. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. He's going to be able to get the trade back onto Victor, get the kill, and now the T is going to be looking to push in towards B through apartments. As they've got the rotation coming in through short as well, but Waylander, he's got this Deagle looking to go in for the 1D. Misses a shot, but returns it through the wall on Lommy. What is going on? These 1Ds coming out hard and fast. They've made these Deagles completely worth their while as they're shutting down two of the players. Now KD going to be pushing through short, takes down Markloff. 3-on-3 situation, 2 CTs over towards A, 1 in market area. Looking to be able to push in. He has got the Deagle, so if they play the angle, but unfortunately, the angle's not in his favor. Tensuke peeks it, takes a shot, wall bangs him, and now time. We're looking at 8 seconds left as the bomb goes down. So 4 seconds left before he would have had no time. And now, do you try and even bother saving this Deagle? I don't know. I mean, they know there's a drop over towards short, but if they try and play that, they could end up losing the Deagle and lose the chance of the exit frags. So I think they might just be playing for these. I mean, Cadian could get dropped here by whatever. If it's not careful, he goes for the Deagle instead of the peak. That's a little bit strange, but now he's going to be playing aggressive. He gets one kill, going in for the second one, but he knows if he loses his M4, it's going to damage their economy. They can't risk that. The Deagle gets picked up by Bubble in the end. They're all going to be peeking him. He's only got USP. What's he going to do? He does a lot of damage and eventually going to get tapped away as he didn't really stand too much of a chance. I mean, these players have quite low HP, so that was actually a lot closer than the T's might have wanted. So this is the chance that Flipside need to try and take a full advantage of. And that is going to be trying to reset the economy on the T side. But unfortunately for them, they let 3 players survive. And that's going to be still a lot of money in the back, so they can be able to buy up the next round nonetheless. Even if Rogue don't win this round. So it's going to be buy versus buy, but it's going to be 2 Famuses, a UMP M4 versus a full barrage of rifles. And Wild Edit is going to get erupt. And we're going to be seeing the rotation from B, from Markloff. He's going to be looking to push in, but we've got Electronic on stairs with the Famus going to be trying to make full use of that. He's going to get flashed as one has crossed over, but if they're not careful, he's going to be able to get the kill. He does a little bit of damage. The bomb is going to be going down, and Tensky, he's rotated through towards stairs. He's got the angle on connector. He has spotted out Blade, but he's going to get sprayed upon and taken down. Cadian peeks in towards mid, has spotted out. Waylander frags him as well. Electronic going to be looking to try and counter this. Peeks in towards there. Through stairs, on towards Jay. He's going to get punished now. Markloff, he's done a lot of damage previously with this Famous. He continues his reign. Gets a kill, and it's going to be a 2-on-2. Bubble, he really is on fire today. That name is so appropriate. He's doing so well. AWP is going to get recovered. And this is going to be the shutdown of the CTs. They're going to have to back off and try and lick their wounds, as they are now going to be another round behind Team Rogue. Oh, look at Cadian. He's done it once again, 25-11. Absolutely beautiful. Previously, we've seen him, I think it was on the first day. Obviously, we're on the third day now. He went 23 to, I think it was 6 or something like that on overpass. It was something absolutely ridiculous. And now we're going to be seeing him do fantastically again. I mean, obviously, we're quite a few rounds into the second half. I mean, we've not had 5 rounds. We're now on the 6th round. And we're going to be on the 21st round in total. Flip side, only on 7 rounds gained, and Rogue 13, so I only need another 3. Molly coming out from Cadian, who's going to be playing very aggressively. He's got the peak on the player who's pushing over towards bench. Luckily for Waylander, he hasn't pushed too aggressively, and he hasn't got the fragged. Now Tensky going to go recover the bomb, making sure no one's played aggressively towards ramp, which hasn't happened because look at that. 4 CT players over towards B, and they've been duped. So Wild Edit going to be the only player over towards the A site. Blade, the only player with the M4. That's a little bit of a strange one there, but he had the cash. Still got 3k in the bank. So rotation has come back out from the CTs, back over towards the A site rather, and the push in towards the A site is going to be coming out any second from Rogue to try and take over this, but they've got a player coming up behind them now. Waylander could be the thorn in their back that I really don't want. Lummi does get the entry kill that they need, but it's still a 4 versus 5 situation. CTs could still do a lot of damage on Blade, pushes in, gets a kill, and Waylander picking up the AK for his trouble, taking down Lummi, takes out Bubble. No, not going to happen. Not going to be seeing Bubble take down Waylander. Waylander going to be a little bit disappointed with that result, and now Tenzin going to be playing aggressive over towards stairs. Once again, does the spray, takes down one, looking in for the second. What a hit. Gets stabbed away. They're now 7 rounds behind Rogue, and Rogue looking to try and take it to match point here. Enough money in the bank to be able to buy for their last 2 rounds. This round and the following round, let's see what they can do, guys. Flipside, on the other hand, they're going to be able to buy by 4 barrage of utility, not for maximum. They've got no defuse kits, that's important to note. They have got the M4s and the AWP, and Electronic going to be playing a slightly different angle here underneath the Palace. Now this push into mid from the T's could be quite devastating for the CT's, but the counter mover the movement could come out from Blade, who's over in towards Connector. Looking to see what he can do, but Victor's going to be looking to try and counter that sort of position held, rather. And see if he can counter them, and now Waylander going to be over towards B. Lummi looking to play aggressive here as well. Electronic going to be backing out over towards Palace. He realizes there could be some aggression coming out over towards the A site. They've seen some grenades in that. Montov as well going to be able to confirm that, but we're going to be seeing Bubble just back off. And Bubble, he's doing fantastically. 16 to 12 might not be the highest kill streak, sort of kill KD rather, you could see, but still fantastic. Especially when you kind of go sort of compare it to the opposite side and his teammates, he is doing very well. And just some of the kills he's had have just been really high impact in very difficult situations, and compared to his last few games, I think he's on a high. Lummi has pushed through that smoke, and now Waylander, he's going to expose himself, he's going to get dropped, and this is going to be the entry that he's won. Now they're just going to be looking to push through, the bomb is out, over, and they're completely exposed. Markov gets the early damage, but not the kill, as he's going to get tagged out by Tenzki, and eventually dropped, his head going to be popped. And the B-side completely taken over, and Cajun played aggressive through the smoke and connector, and get the frag on Electronic as well, and now there's one player left, and it's going to be Wald at it. And even though he can dream, he's going to try and get 5 kills with this AWP and try and get the defuse, even without a defuse kit. Unfortunately for him, Tenzi is going to be looking to play up against him, going in for the wall banks there. Not going to happen. Wardhead is going to get the first kill and the second one onto Tenzi. So he's done 2. Is he going to be able to get 3? That is going to be the real challenge here. No, it doesn't look like he is, as Bubble is going to get the drop on him. Potentially the final round here, guys, on Mirage. I'm not quite sure what the next map is. HLTV has not been updated. Unless I'm wrong, let's check right now. Boom, Cash. Cash is the next one. Who doesn't love some Dust 2? No. Yeah, Cash is pretty much the Dust 2 of the UK. And pretty much as Dust 2 is out of the map range, pretty much call it Dust 2. Cool Cash does too. So moving into the next and potentially final round, we're going to be seeing the CTs trying to fight with everything they've got. Full barrage of FAMAS's and UMPs, as much utility as combined. This time they've got defuse kit though. And it's important as well to know that Cadian is going to be able to get a kill on Electronic, but we're going to be seeing I was lost for words there. Lummi spray through the smoke, takes down Waylander, reading the situation perfectly. Now 2 CTs left on the final round. Is it going to be the final round, rather? We've got Markloff trying to hold over towards B alone, Blade over towards A and Connector. He's going to have to try and clutch out, but Cadian gets the no scope, gets the final kill, and that's going to be Blade dropped. So that is the first map. Mirage going over to the side of Rogue. Absolutely fantastic work done there. And we're going to be going into a short break, guys, whilst we wait for the next map, Cash, to start.